About myself, my name is Sovit Manjani, and I'm a chartered market technician, and I have experience in financial markets for almost 10 years now. Okay, I am the co-founder and partner at Dravyaniti, and I head the trading strategies and application division at Dravyaniti. I have designed various algorithms on trend following, and I'm using them and running them on my own account and on the client's account. Okay, and that's why I'm able to combine strategy with combine theory with practical. Okay, I've also developed these systems in stocks, indices, futures. Okay, and these all are like automated systems, and they use position sizing techniques as well. Okay. So, and I trained for all three levels of CMT, okay, and I've trained for the automated trading also, okay. So, who should attend CMT? Who should attend CMT level 1 classes? So, anybody who's trying to give level 1 in 2019 December can attend this course. Okay. And anybody who's interested in technical analysis or systematic trading is also eligible to attend this class. What are the basic career options available for doing CMTs? So you can be independent traders, you can be analysts, mentors, authors, you can design systems, you can be risk managers, you can design strategies, okay. You can be a fund manager, you can make options applications, hedge fund managers, option traders, okay, and you can create your own indicator, your own methodology, okay, after doing these courses, okay. And who employs CMTs? Basically, exchanges employ CMTs, hedge funds, proprietary desks, brokerage houses, trading groups like LICs can also hire CMTs, and any other financial institutions can hire CMT. Generally, CMTs use mathematics and data and analytical techniques to manage the risk and chart existing market prices to show trends and future pricing. So basically, in charting, there are two basic divisions. One is trend following, another is mean reversion. Okay, so both can be done through technical analysis. The opportunities are immense, and rewards are great. You will all be able to ask me questions through chat. Okay, once this presentation is done. Okay, so keep your questions, or you can keep posting your questions, and I'll be answering them after the presentation. Most of your questions will be answered in this presentation, but if something is not answered, then you can put it on the chat and I'll answer them. The CMT program is basically a professional designation. It's the highest designation in technical analysis all over the world. It's conducted by CMT Association, which is based in New York, and they monitor the examination. It confirms the proficiency in technical analysis. It's the highest designation available on technical analysis. The program consists of three exam levels offered twice each year. There are three levels, level 1, level 2, level 3, and you can give examination twice in a year. Okay. That is generally in June and December. This requires completion of an education program and examination series in technical analysis. So basically, we'll have to complete the education, that is the basic study material which they provide, and you have to attend for the examination. After that, and clearing all the three levels, you get the CMT designation. CMT Association oversees the program, curriculum and administration of exams. So they design the curriculum and they design the exam. Yeah. And the tests are conducted in Pro Matrix Center. Right now the center is in Goregaon. Okay. Every year the program sees minor revision in order of 10% or less. Major enhancements are done in 5 years interval. So every year they may change the curriculum by around 10%, but every 5 years they do a major change. Last major change was done in 2015, and maybe like in 2020 they will make another change. Okay, in 2015 they put they remove a lot of subjective analysis and introduced a lot of objective analysis. The curriculum makes sure that the practitioner apply technical analysis with discipline and objectivity to remove subjective bias from their process. So the basic objective of the curriculum is to like any technical analysis should be used objectively. It should give you clear signals and not subjective thing that this, if this happens then you do this, if this happens then you do this. Basically it should be objective, either true or false. Okay, it should be binary, it should not be like too complicated. Then only basically we can make money out of markets. Otherwise, if you are too subjective, then all the options will be open. Illustrate the complementary nature of technical analysis with other disciplines, including fundamental analysis, quantitative analysis, and macroeconomics. So basically, technical analysis is not too go against any other analysis. It go hand in hand with other analysis like fundamental analysis, quantitative analysis, and even macroeconomics. Okay, so it's not to prove anybody wrong. It's that we have to like technical analysis works together with other analysis also. Equip CMTs with an ability to apply technical analysis as a means of risk management in the portfolio content. So basically, technical analysis also has inbuilt risk management things, okay, and and portfolio management also is covered within this program, okay. So generally, risk is extremely important because if you lose money, you will not be able to trade again, okay. So and we manage risk by various portfolio. Position sizing techniques, portfolio diversification. So that also comes within the program. Okay, so basically most of that part will be in level 3, but the overall program takes care of that part as well. It provides a disciplined systematic approach to understanding the law of supply and demand in liquid markets across all asset classes. It covers all the asset classes. Technical analysis works in almost all the asset classes, including currencies, commodities, equities, futures. Okay. So, and basically, it's the study of supply and demand. Okay. Wherever there's a supply, okay, and where there's demand, based on that, the stock will move up and down. A bachelor's degree in finance, business, or economics is the minimum requirement. So, there's a minimum requirement that you have to be a master. A bachelor in any field. Okay, so if you are not a master bachelor as of now, but you are you will be doing it after say 6 months or 1 year, then also you can pursue CMT. okay, only thing is that you will not get the designation till you pursue your bachelor's degree. Okay, so you can give the exams, but you will get the degree only when you have the bachelor's degree also. Okay. And of course, they also require 3 years experience. Okay. So some of the study traps which students get into, so just be careful of these traps. Because the majority of the CMT candidates utilize more elements of technical analysis in their job functions, there's great potential for bias to sneak into your studying and preparation. Okay. So many people already are using technical analysis. Okay, so this gives a like bias that they already know technical analysis, but CMT curriculum is like you will learn much more than you are already doing. And in some cases, you'll have to unlearn things which you are doing, and you have to relearn some things. Okay. So the number one is, assuming you know technical analysis, approach your studies with assumption that there are potential gaps in your knowledge and be eager to discover, learn new tools, concepts that can improve your professional performance. Okay. So have an open mind. Okay, there may be something new which you may learn using within this program. There will be many things which you will learn within this program. Okay, in all three levels. Okay, you may be knowing a lot of things, but then there are a lot of things which you will not be knowing, and you may know within this program. Trap number two is, assuming you will pass the exam because you have passed other exams like CFA designation in the past. Okay. Again, if people think that they have already cleared CFA or they have cleared any other such exams, okay. But CMT is little different, not only intellectually, but the study is like, it has a lot of practical approach, okay. So till you don't use them in your daily, day-to-day life, okay, you will not be like able to get grip on those subjects. Like if you don't see the charts and you just read the books, you may pass CFA, but you may not pass CMT. Okay, CMT has a lot of practical things in the curriculum. So it is very, very essential that you see charts. Okay, just don't try to read books and give exams. Also try to see charts and then decide whatever is given in the curriculum or whatever is taught by the mentor, okay, should be practiced. Okay, if you don't do that, then it will be a little difficult to clear CMT. Tab number three is that, assuming you are ready because you will read all of the study material and understand that recommendations are just recommendations, and you need to emphasize certain subject areas more than others. So, firstly, as I said, there's a lot of practical component in the curriculum, especially in level 2. Okay. So, and also understand that whatever recommendations is there in the program, they are only recommendations. It doesn't mean that this is limited to these aspects. Okay. There may be more things which have to be learned. Okay. So don't concentrate only on the curriculum. You have to like have some practical knowledge as well. Okay. So for level one, they assess the candidate based on these three things. First is recognition. They expect you to recognize certain patterns, certain indicators. Okay. So recognition is what is expected. Okay. Another thing is the definitions of some of the within the curriculum, there are a lot of definitions. They expect you to know the definitions, like what are the different types of classes, like how does equity work, how does futures work. All those things and options, all those things, basic definitions have to be clear. And the basic understanding and concepts are within technical analysis. So like the various indicators, moving averages, RSIs, okay, so basic concepts of them. They don't expect you to have advanced knowledge of them, but the basic understanding has to be there. Now, total reading material is around 750 pages, okay. As per association, around 100 hours are required for preparing, but I have seen that 100 hours may not be enough. You may have to put little more hours. Okay, so I expect around 200 hours. That is like from now till December, your exam will be near about December 6th to December 16th or 15th. Okay, so you have around 4.5 months. So if you study every day around 2 hours, that should be enough for you. Okay. In any week, if you are not able to give 2 hours each day, then you can cover it up and on Saturdays and Sundays. Okay, but try to give at least 2 hours for the level one exam. Okay. Practical training and regularly reading price charts often helps in the performance. Okay, so you'll have to read the price chart, and there are many softwares which are freely available, or there are websites like NetDania, investing.com, TradingView. You can see the charts there. You don't need to buy any software. You don't need to spend money on those things. Okay. You can just see the charts and apply the basic concepts on the charts. Okay. No need to buy. Like when I was giving level one, I bought software, but now that is not required. There are so many softwares or websites available with basic indicators and that. So you will not require any other thing. You can just, but put, you will have to give time. That is for sure. Okay. The exam consists of 120 multiple choice questions plus 12 pre-test questions. Okay. So they are 100. You are marked at for 120 multiple choice questions, but then they also have 12 pre-test questions. That is, you have to answer 132 questions. Okay, but you will mark only on 120 questions, and you will be getting 2 hours time. It's not 2 hours 15 minutes; it's 2 hours. Okay, previously it used to be 2 hours 15 minutes, but now they reduced to 2 hours. Exams are conducted in Promatic Center, currently situated down west. There is no negative marking. Okay, so you don't need to worry about negative marks. Okay, your target should be to get at least 75% to comfortably clear the level one. So you should target 75%. Okay, anything less than that, they don't give the exact percentage. What is the passing percentage? But what we have seen is that if you score 75 and above, then you most probably will clear the exam. Candidates may only sit for one exam in each examination, each administration. Basically, you cannot give level 1 and level 2 together, or level 2 and level 3 together. You have to give level 1 first, and then after 6 months only you can give level 2, and after 6 months only you can give level 3. Okay. There is no limitation on candidates' ability to retake exams. So there is nothing that there are n number of retakes. You can have n number of retakes, but we basically don't want to do that, because each retake will cost you at least 35,000-40,000 rupees. Okay. No time limit is for the candidate to pass the subsequent levels. So if you pass level one like in December, then there's no limitation that level 2 you have to give it within 6 months or 1 year. You can give after 5 years also. Basically, we don't like to do that, because it's when we clear the exam in the flow, it is better. Okay, don't give gaps. I would suggest that, although you can have gaps, okay, but I would suggest not to keep gaps, because then you tend to your rhythm gets disturbed. And you may afterwards you may think that let's not do it or something or other, will keep on coming. Okay, so it's better to give it in one shot. Okay. CFA charter holders are granted an exemption from CMT level 1 exam. So if you are a chartered holder of CFA and you have the designation, then you don't need to give level 1. You can directly start with level 2. Okay. Now, chapter-wise learning objectives. So basically, the first section is theory and history of technical analysis. Okay, the basic principle of technical analysis, the trend. So we start with the first chapter is based on trends and how to identify a trend, and what are the basic principles of technical analysis. Okay. Then the second chapter talks about Dow theory. Okay. The basic principles of or 6 tenets of Dow theory, and the 3 types of markets, which is primary, secondary, and minor markets, that will be covered. Okay, the concept of confirmation in Dow theory. Okay, in Dow theory, there is a concept of confirmation where if Dow Jones and industrial average is making new highs and making higher and higher lows, okay, then the railroad should also make higher and higher low. Okay, so that is the confirmation part, and the role of volume. As per also the volume is very important. Okay, so volume should be in sync with the price. Okay, then history and construction of charts. Basically, what are the major types of charts like bar charts, candlesticks, point and figure? Those all are covered, and the there are two scales, basically arithmetic scale and logarithmic scale. So those will be covered. Then the second section begins with which is on charts, trends and patterns. So again, we cover the trend and the tools to recognize trend. Okay, like moving averages, trend lines. Okay, then how to recognize downtrend, uptrend and sideways market using these tools. Okay, and then concept of support and resistance and identify trends using most common methods. So how will you identify the trend? Okay, whether it is sideways or downward or upward trending. Okay, then identify significant reversal points. So where, what are the points where the price may reverse? Okay, so how to identify them and what are the characteristics on chart to see the reversals? And then we covered chapter 5 is on breakouts, stops and retracements. So how to identify breakouts and then recognizing the signals from the breakouts. Okay, and what will be a stop loss for any strategy or any trade. Okay, and how, what should be the entry points and exit points basically, and how to describe the methods for setting entry and exit stops. Okay, so how you use the stop losses and entry points. Then within that we covered moving averages, like various types of moving averages, and like there are simple moving averages, there are exponential moving averages, weighted moving average, welder's moving average. There are many types of moving averages. So that all will be covered here. And describe and interpret direction momentum indicators. Direction momentum indicators is the positive DMI and negative DMI, and then there's something called EDX. That will be covered here. And the characteristics of envelopes, channels and bands. There are various types of envelopes like percentage envelopes, and channels are there like Gartner channels and Stark channels, and there are bands like Bollinger bands. So all that will be covered within this chapter. Then bar chart patterns, basic this patterns like flags, pennants, triangles, head and shoulder, double top, triple top, all those will be covered in this chapter. Okay, and the historical performance measures of the chart patterns. So basically historically how these patterns have performed. Okay, so if there's a head and shoulder pattern, how it has performed in the past, how many times it has given like a breakout and it has given an X percentage move after that. Okay, so that all statistics is covered here. Then short term patterns, identify long term patterns using short term price patterns. Okay, short term patterns, there are various patterns like gaps and like wide range bars, inside day, outside day. Okay, and candlestick patterns. So how you will use those tools to find short-term patterns. Okay, gaps will be covered in this chapter, and candlestick patterns will be covered in this pattern in this chapter. Okay, then there is a concept of confirmation. Okay, so price chart should be confirmed by volume or some other parameters like open interest. Okay, so that will be covered here. Okay. And various indices and their oscillators. Okay, and designed to use volume as confirmation. So these oscillators will can be like breadth oscillators, and sentiment indicators, all those will be covered here. Open interest and how it might be used for confirmation. Open interest and volume are used for confirmation. Okay, if there's high open interest and the stock is moving up, then it confirms that the uptrend is continuing. If it is high open interest and the stock is moving down, then it is an indicator that the stock will continue to fall. Okay. The concept of momentum in price action. So if the price action is confirmed by the momentum, like momentum indicators like RSI, ROC, MACD, stochastics, so that all will be covered here. And characteristics of the most commonly used indexes and oscillators. So what are the characteristics of indices? Okay, like Nifty, Bank Nifty. Okay, and what oscillators can be used on them? Candlestick charting essentials. So this chapter covers the candlestick part. Okay, these two chapter 10. Okay, this describes the strength and limitation of candlestick charts. Like candlestick charts are extremely useful, but then they have a disadvantage that candlestick charts will not give you targets. Okay, so you have to understand that. Identify the components of individual candlestick lines, real body and shadows. So candles have two parts. One is real body and the other is shadows. So how to identify that and what is the importance of shadows and real bodies? How candles graphically depict the high, low, open and close of the trading period. So how high, low and open, close can define the next day move or the future move. Okay, the current day's open, high, low, close can give you some indication of the future move. Okay, so how to understand that? Okay, identify candle formation of support and resistance. Okay, so which candle patterns are formed at support and resistance and how it reacts after that? Okay, that all will be covered here. Then there is a charting concept called quantum figure charting. Okay, so how these charts are constructed, that will be covered. And then the importance of box size, there's something called box size in quantum figure. Okay, so how you should use box size and how you should, there's something called reversal, box size reversal. Okay, so what reversal size you should take, that all will be covered here. Okay, and construction, various box size reversal point and figure charts. The construction part and the these box charts also give targets. Okay, so how to calculate targets using quantum figure charts, and how to get entry points and exit points using quantum figure chart, that will be covered. And the section 3 covers the advanced concept of charting and trend analysis. So basically now here we covered Elliott wave principle, okay, the basic elements of Elliott wave, and the difference between impulsive wave and corrective waves. There are two types of impulsive waves, motive waves and corrective waves. Okay, and there are three types of corrective waves, like triangle, flat, and zigzag. So all that will be covered, the basics of Elliott wave. And the next chapter covers the targets part, like Fibonacci ratios, and then how to give targets using Elliott wave. Okay, the count of given wave is in a defined structure. Identify whether a technical study fails into one of the three categories, trend following oscillators and sentiment indicators. So basically, you have to recognize whether the market is trending or it is oscillating. Okay. Then we cover market strength. So basic measures of internal market strength, like breadth indicators, explain measures of breadth indicators, okay, and recognize signals of changes in market breadth using the advanced decline line. Advanced decline line is again a breadth indicator. Okay, how you can understand the market based on that indicator. Okay, interpret signals of changing market strength with volume data. Okay, so here the volume is not the normal stock volume, here is the volume of the overall market. Okay, so how the overall market volume of the market can give you an indication of the market. Okay, identify the measures of market strength with high, low, and high and new high and new low data. So basically, this is again a breadth indicator which uses which calculates the number of stocks which are making new highs or new lows. So if there are a lot of stocks which are making new highs, this is a bullish indicator. Okay, so this will tell you that the overall market is bullish. Okay, if the market is making new highs, but the there are a lot of stocks which are making new 52-week lows. So that means that the market is internally it is weak, and only the few stocks are keeping the market up. Which has been being doing in the last one and a half years in Indian markets. Recognize measures of market strength based on number of stocks picked around priced above their moving averages. So again, if there are a lot of stocks which are above their say 200 day moving average, okay, so which is bullish. Okay, if the market is making new highs, but there are a lot of stocks which are below the 200 day moving average, although the market is making new highs, but the indicator says that the market is weak. It is making new highs, but a lot of stocks are making new are below the 200 day moving average. Okay, so that gives you a advance like warning that you don't have to be in the market. Then we cover cycle analysis. Okay, name the two types of cycles and then the three defining characteristics of a cycle. So what are the characteristics of a cycle? Okay, and defining the cycles based on Hertz's seven principles. Okay, that will be covered here. Define composite wave. Composite wave is one way of finding out cycles. Left and right translation. So cycles have either left translation or right translations. So based on that, you can identify whether the trend will be up or down. Okay, and describe a dominant cycle. So which is the dominant cycle? Like there are multiple cycles at one time. So you have to identify which is the dominant cycle, and based on that, you go within that, you see another cycle, and within that, you see another cycle. Okay. Recall the tools which aid in cycle identification. And there are various tools to identify cycles. Okay. So which will be covered here. Then basics of cycle analysis, explain how the annual cycle confirms the cycle theory. So there are various cycles, as I said. So there's an annual cycle, and then within that there will be 6-monthly cycle, and there will be a 3-monthly cycle. Okay. And describe two methods of detrending market data. Okay. So detrending is a method of removing trend out of the price. Okay, so we remove trend out of the price to get the cycle. And basically, there are four components in a price. Okay, which is trend, cycle, seasonality, and cyclicality. Noise. Okay. So when we remove trend, okay, we cannot remove noise. So what is left is seasonality and cycles. Okay. So seasonality and cycles are very similar. Basically, cycles are a longer term cycle, and seasonality are like shorter term cycles. Okay. So based on that, we can get the cycles. If you remove trend, we can get the cycles. Okay. So how we can remove trends from the price to understand the cycles? Then reshape common seasonal tools. So there are some tools for seasonality that will be covered, and memorize notable economic cycles and their periods. Which are the most important cycles, and what are their periods? Like quarterly wave is a 54-year wave. Then there are like presidential cycles of 4 years. Okay. So all that will be covered here. We call some sequence and non-linear cycles. So there are two types of cycles, again, sequences and non-linear, that will be covered here. Then we have markets and mortality. Okay, this is the basic definitions of market. Okay, so various instruments in the market, like what are the various asset classes, okay, and five tradable instruments that technician is likely to employ, so like currencies, commodities, equities, and bonds. Okay, so all of these will be covered, and all and there's real estate also, but then real estate is not that liquid. Data handling issues with which a technician should be familiar. So when we are doing technical analysis, the most important thing for us is the data. Okay. So how to understand data and then how to handle the data. Data itself is a very complex thing, and which has to be cleared, and it has to be clean. Because if the data is not clean, your whole analysis will be wrong. If there are gaps in the data, like if the stock split and bonuses are not been adjusted in your data, then your whole analysis will not be correct. Okay, so the data handling is very important. Then with the asset classes, we cover equities. Okay, defining the equities, equities, securities, and primary data types. The benefits of equities for investors. The concept of corporate actions on price data, like stock split and bonus and dividends. Okay, then classifying sectors, capitalization, and other ways to segment the market. So how you, how the market is segmented, and how the sectors are there, and then capitalization, like large cap, mid cap, and small caps are there. Okay, so all that will be covered here. Then we have indices. So which are the major world indices? Okay, like Dow Jones, S&P 500, NASDAQ, FTSE 100, and CAC 40, and Nifty 50. Okay, so all these will be covered here. Okay. Then name common non-equity indices used by technical analysis, like commodity index is there. And then explain the weighing method used in major indices. So each indices is made in a different way. The weighing methods are different for each index. Like Nifty will be weighted differently, and Dow Jones weighted differently. Okay, so that will be there. Then define survivorship bias. Survivorship bias is something like the stocks which are right now present in NSE, they have survived till now. Okay, but there were a lot of stocks which were there in 2008, which died down within the next 10 years. So when you are backtesting or making any strategy, okay, you are not you cannot take only the stocks which are present now. You have to take those stocks which were there in 2008, because if you were running the system in 2008. Okay, what would have been the results? Okay, these stocks are still survived. So then, if you are making a long-only strategy and you are taking only the stocks which have survived, then it will give you incorrect results, because it will not show you those stocks in which you would have lost money, because they died down. Okay, they were delisted. Okay, for any reason, maybe they were bankrupt, or maybe for any other reason like mergers or acquisition. Okay, but survivorship bias is an extremely important concept which very few people understand. Okay, then fixed income and bonds cover. So basically, there are another asset class of called bonds, which are not very active in Indian markets, but then in US and other markets, they are very. They are the, in fact, bonds are the most traded instrument in US markets. Then list the major types of issuers of debt securities. Identify the basic terms of debt in the instrument, including duration, maturity, coupon, issuer. So all these are the terms for this. So these are the definitions which you have to remember. okay, state the ways in which debt prices are expressed and explain the relation between price and yield. Okay, so bond prices are different and yield are different. Okay, so that relationship is there. Mostly that is an inverse relationship. Okay, defining yield curve. Okay. There's something called yield curve, which is like there's a difference between short term interest rates and longer term interest rates. That defines the yield curve. Okay. So that will be covered here. Okay. Describe the importance of US government debt in the pricing of other debt securities, yield or spread. So these all will be covered here. Then futures, futures market will be covered. I explain the purpose of futures market. Basically, future market uses leverage, okay, and you can like have both way trades in that. You can have a short trade also in cash. You cannot have short trades at position short trades. But in US market, you can also have position shorts in cash also. Okay. Classify various futures market as industrial, agriculture, financial, and so on. So futures are into various classifications like industrials, agriculture, and financials. Okay, list the major terms of futures contract, or that will be covered here. Then define open interest in futures and describe challenges technical analysts face using futures market data. So there's a difference between cash market data and futures market data. Like in futures market, it's not a continuous contract because every 3 months, as we understand, that the futures expire. Okay, so then these futures data have to be made continuous. Okay, so that's a challenge which will be covered here. Then we cover exchange traded products like ETFs. Okay. What is the definition of ETF, and then review difference between exchange traded funds and exchange traded notes, and the uses of uses for leverage ETPs. Okay, so these can be leveraged. Okay, so how we use that. Okay, then foreign exchange is currencies. So identify the base and put currencies in pair. So in a currency, you understand currency is always a pair. So there's a base currency and there's a port currency. Okay. And then classify currency pairs as major or cross. So there are major currencies and there are cross currencies. Okay. That all definition will be covered. Discuss the impact of technical analysis of the dealer market system of currency trading. Okay. So all the market of currency is different. Okay. Explain the data used in building currency charts. So again, currency charts are used with the data, okay, and what precautions you should take in currency data, okay, and describe cryptocurrencies. So there's a small note on cryptocurrencies. Okay. Then we cover options also. Explain the purpose of options market. What is the use of options market? Basically, options are used for hedging, okay, but then people speculate also on them. Okay. List the major terms of the option contracts. Okay, define the Greeks. So some of the Greeks, only the basic definition of Greeks is covered here. Okay, and define implied volatility. Understanding implied volatility. Discuss the difference between historical and implied volatility. So historical volatility is different and implied volatility is different. Okay, so this the difference will be covered here. And identify the concept of put call parity. There's a concept of put call parity which will be explained here. And calculate single day implied volatility. So implied volatility is generally yearly. Then we have to calculate on for a single day. So that can be covered here. Then we cover VIX index, describing definition of the VIX index, and explain the implementation of rising and falling VIX index. So basically, VIX index is inversely proportional to market prices. Okay, so if the market is going up, VIX index will be going down, and the VIX index is going high, that means that the market may be bearish. And when VIX index is down, that means the market may be bullish. Then section 5 contains behavioral finance and other theories of market dynamics. This includes efficient market hypothesis, a basic concept, and the characteristics of stock prices. Then we cover EMH and the market model. So we cover the CAPM model, okay, and where criticisms of CAPM model. So this all part is like theory, okay. The forerunners are to behavioral finance, contrast momentum strategies and mean reverting strategies. Define the general concept of value investing. Describe why value investing is similar to mean reversion strategy. All this will be covered. Then noise traders and the law of one price. Describe the concept of fungibility and identifying what defines the noise trader. Then we have chapter 31, noise traders as technical and technical traders. So explain why technical traders are considered as specific type of noise trader. All these are like theory and we'll be covering that. Explain the implementation of the technical analysis in the market. Then academic approaches of technical analysis, the contrast EMH and the adaptive market hypothesis will be covered here. And then how technical analysis remains relevant despite EMH. So EMH is the theory which is against technical analysis, and even with EMH, how technical analysis have survived and given good results. Chapter 33 is like market sentiment and technical analysis. So how to identify technical sentiments in the market, define sentiment and it relates to financial markets. Then identify general categories of informed and uninformed participants. Using sentiment indicators. So all the sentiment indicators will be covered here, like newspaper or magazine covers and all that will be covered here. Then chapter 34 is again sentiment measures from market data. So describe VIX as a sentiment measure. As I said, VIX is inversely proportional to stock market price. So when the VIX is up, market is generally down, and when the market is up, then the mix is down. Explain the use of volume options. Volume and open interest. Again, is an indicator of the sentiment of the market. The use of futures options identify the US markets. Okay. So we'll be studying how to read that report and how to understand what the market sentiment is based on that. Okay. Defining short interest and then explain in insider activities as a sentiment indicator. Again, insider trading gives you an idea about the sentiment of the market. Sentiment measures for external data. So discuss the use of news and advisory on sentiment measures. So news also gives you sentiment measure. Okay. And how when a lot of analysts are bullish, then the market sentiment may be very bullish, and then it's a contra indicator. Okay. Explain the concept of contrary opinion. So when a lot of analysts are bullish, then the probability is that the stock will fall. Or when a lot of analysts are bearish, then the probability is high that the market will rise. Indicate how mutual fund cash and other funds measures are used to gauge sentiment. You can use mutual fund data and other funds data to gauge the sentiment of the market. Then section 4 consists of basic statistics. Here we introduce the descriptive statistics, which includes the basic mean, median, mode, the measure of settled tendency, then the measures of dispersion, various methods of calculating means, okay, and measure of measures of dispersion. So here basically we cover measure of dispersion is nothing but standard deviation, variance, okay, which should be covered here. Okay, H2 measures of dispersion, standard deviation, and variance. So that will be covered here. State the value of data visualization as a complement of descriptive statistics. So how to see the data, okay, and how the statistics may help you understand the data. Okay. Then introduction to probability. Okay, so basically understanding this understanding is extremely important for a trader, that markets are nothing but a game of probability. Okay, there's no certainty. Okay, anybody who says that this will definitely happen doesn't understand the market. Okay, only a person who is a good trader will understand that there is a higher probability or lower probability. There's never certainty. Never you can say that this stock will certainly go up and this stock will certainly go down, or the market will certainly go up or the market will certainly go down. Okay, you can just say that with the probability. Okay, but there is a 60% probability that the market will go up. Explain the impact of a law of large numbers on a series of outcomes. Okay, so a law of large numbers is extremely important concept, because if you have a trading system and it has only very few trades, like in 5 years it has only 30 trades, then those 30 trades are not enough to gauge that system, because those 30 trades may be just because of luck. It's a concept that in a short number of trades, or short number of any observations, there is a luck factor is extremely high. Okay. When the observations are more, like 500, then you can say with certainty that that this can be the profitability. Okay, but when the observations are very less, then the outcomes may not be reliable. Define random variable and the phase independent and identically distributed. Okay, so there's something called random variance. Okay, so that all concept will be covered here. Describe a normal probability distribution. Okay, so some of you maybe may understand what is normal distribution. Okay, so that all will be covered here. Okay, and then identify skewness and kurtosis. So in normal distribution, there can be skewness and kurtosis, which are the two things which are there, which will be covered here. Objective rules and their evaluation. Identify how to distinguish an objective from a subjective rule in technical analysis. So basically, technical analysis is more about objective rules. Okay. Anything subjective, like if this happens, then this will happen, or if that happens, this will happen, that is very subjective. You have to be objective. To make money, you need to be objective. Either this or that. It can be either true or it can be false. There's no third option. There cannot be a gray area. Either you win or you lose, or you make money or you lose money. Okay. Discuss the use of binary rules and individual or multiple thresholds. Okay. And recognize the difference between traditional rules and inverse rules. Okay, the traditional rules and inverse rules will be covered here. Inverse rules, I'll be explaining you at that time of the lecture. Okay. And then recognize the difference between regular prices and detrended prices. Okay, there are regular prices which we see, and there are detrended prices which from which we can remove the trend and then see the chart, which will be like more of a like cyclical. Then chapter 39 will be talking about being right and making money. identify the four characteristics of debt dealers claims are common to successful investors, and identify 9 rules to consider when building a timing model. So there are some rules to build a model, so that will be covered here. Explain the logic of moving averages as trend indicators. So moving averages is extremely important tool for identifying trends. So that they will be covering here. Okay. Chapter 40 is the model building process. Describe the use of advisory service opinion as a sentiment indicator. So how advisory services can be a sentiment indicator? Recognizing the difference between sentiment and valuation indicators. So there is a difference between sentiment indicator and valuation indicators. So that will be covered. Describe the main tools that Federal Reserve uses to adjust the money supply. So Federal Reserve is the US RBI, you can say, okay, and how they adjust the money supply. Interpret the likely results of changes in Fed monetary policy tools and market conditions. Okay, so these are all theory which we will be covering. Identify the outcome of good economic indicator reading and the likely influence of this news on stock prices. So how the economic indicators can affect stock prices, and recognize how moving averages of stock prices can be included in forecasting model. So we can have a forecasting model which can use moving averages instead of prices, and then recognize how momentum indicators can be included in the forecasting model. So again, momentum indicators like RSI, stochastics, MACD can be used for in a model. Then the last chapter is on relative strength. Relative strength is a category for investment selection. So how you use relative strength for taking a decision of buying a stock. Okay. So how relative strength is calculated, the definition of relative strength, and then how relative strength is used. Okay. And the value of relative strength study will be covered here. And then identify correlation coefficient. Correlations are like between stocks and indices, or maybe between stocks and stocks. Now basically, how the CMT program has been defined in terms of like weightages. Okay. So the first section has the weightage of 47%. Okay, so this the first basically 12 chapters has the highest weightage. The first 12 chapters has the highest weightage, which is 47%. Okay, this includes like 5% weightage is given to the construction of charts, which includes the scaling methods like arithmetic or logarithmic charts. Then line charts, bar charts, candlestick charts, trend analysis has 16% weightage, which includes moving averages, regression analysis, and trend lines. Then chart and patterns has 23% weightage. Okay, that is these are patterns like triangles, moving averages. Pennants, flag, okay, and short-term patterns like candlestick patterns, okay. Agent wave and the Fibonacci retracements are covered here. Support and resistance and indicators like RSI, MACD, Bollinger Band, stochastics will be covered here. So this has the highest weightage of which is 23%. And then we have confirmations, which is only 3% weightage, which includes volume and open interest. Then the second section is markets, which has 21% weightage. Okay, this includes theory and history of markets, okay. And basic modern theory, EMH, Dow theory, wave finance, which are only covered here, which is 9% weightage. Then markets itself has only 5% weightage, which has like data and traditional asset classes like equities, fixed income, commodities. Okay. given out to derivatives, private equity, managed futures, real estate. Then we have currencies and non-US markets, market indices and exchange rates section. Market indicators has 7% weightage, which includes breadth indicators like advanced decline line, a number of stocks above a certain moving average or volume. Okay. Then index construction like capitalization of Dow Jones and this Nasdaq. Fair government, federal reports, private money flows, sentiment measures like corp ratio and investors polls. Volatility will be covered here. And together as 7% weightage. Technical and investment strategy has 18% weightage, which includes cycles. And selection and decision making has 13% weightage, which includes relative strength and forecasting techniques like pattern recognition and trend recognition. And system design, we have very less weightage, that is 5%, which includes backtesting, order execution. And statistical analysis has only 6% weightage, which includes mean, median, mode, measure of standard tendency and measure of dispersion, okay, and fundamental probability. Okay. Ethics has only 3% weightage. Now there are two ways of studying the study material. Okay. First is the linear study, that is starting from chapter 1, you do all the chapters till the last chapter. Okay. To continuous work their way through the entire curriculum, chapter by chapter. Okay. This method requires the most amount of time, but is most effective in helping you master the CMT program. So we recommend basically linear study, because the firstly you should be clear with all the concepts and the study material. You read all the chapters one by one. Okay. We will be expanding all the chapters and we will be covering all the chapters. Okay. And you can read the chapters before us and come to the classes, or you can read afterwards, but we recommend you read the chapters before us. And we also take the class based on like chapter by chapter. Okay. We start with chapter 1 and then go to chapter 41. Another way of doing is like which is topical study. This method is far faster, but also presents more risk. Basically, topic wise, like you what we do is like you give more you study first the part which has more weightage. Okay, but then there's a risk that you'll be leaving some of the studies. So basically what we recommend is that the first round you do with a linear study, that means you cover all the chapters first, okay, and then you the second time when you are revising, then you do topic wise study. Okay. In revision you first give more weightage to the topics which have higher weightage. Okay. That is what we recommend. Okay. While the second method may more attractive in terms of time, we recommend linear study and using topical study as a supplement to ensure candidates learn what they need to know. Okay. So we recommend both the studies. First you do linear, and then for revision, basically the second time reading, you can use topic-wise study. Again, which chapters have to be given more focus? Is like 42% weightage is only from chapter 1 to 12. Okay. The highest weightage is for the chapter 1 to 12. Okay. Then market study is 17% weightage, which includes 4 chapters, which is from 13 to 17. Okay. Then strategy and selection has 23% weightage, and major chapters are from 18 to 29. Okay. It's also an important part, which is 23% weightage. Basically, if you see the first 29 chapters has almost 82% weightage. First for 29 chapters has 82% weightage. The first you should focus on the first 29 chapters. Okay. In fact, first 24 chapters have the highest weightage. And then system development and concept, which is 15% weightage, and this is in chapter 23 and chapter 13 to 34. Okay. And ethics has only 3% weightage. The majority of the questions on the exam, 82% are related to the first three categories, and would be derived from those chapters that are bolded in red in the table above. Okay. The red chapters which are in red are most important. A study tip for your various formulas. There are three types of formulas you will encounter. The first is the calculating technical indicators. So there will be formulas for each indicator, moving averages and all. You don't need to remember the formula for these indicators. Okay, but you should understand the elements of the formula. Okay, you don't need to learn and mug the full formula. But understand the elements of the formula. What are the indicators of the formula? Okay. And then second is the expected price movement. Okay, expected price movement formula you have to learn and you and they may ask questions on that. And they have to calculate the exam based on this. Okay, so expected price movement is nothing but doing targets. Like how to calculate targets for like a triangle pattern or a pattern, or how to calculate targets for agent with Fibonacci numbers. And point and figure targets. Formulas you have to remember, and they may ask questions on these formulas. And then there's performance metrics. Performance metrics are like ratios, like sharp ratio, turner ratio, and alpha. Okay. So these also you just have to understand the elements. You don't need to know all the formulas, but understand the indicates like sharp ratio is nothing but your expected return minus the risk period divided by the standard. So you don't need to remember the formula. At least you understand that the numerator is the return and the denominator is the risk. Okay. So if you understand that, that will be you do not need to memorize formulas for calculating technical indicators or performance. But you must understand the elements of the formulas are and their purpose or function and what they require to carry out. Okay. So that you have to remember. And the formula for expected price movement, however, will need to be memorized simply based on their function. So you have to memorize the formula. So this is from my part. Yeah, this is my details and more information you can get from the CMT Association website. This is the link of that. Okay. And this is my number, my two mobile numbers. You can contact me on these numbers. The first number has WhatsApp, the second number doesn't have WhatsApp. These are my two email addresses. This is my personal email address and this is the company email address. And these are my Twitter handle. You can contact me anywhere. And now we can answer your questions. Okay. So, Jasper Shasti, hello, I will come to thanks a lot. I'll thank you for that. Okay. And, lot of noise. Can you please mute all participants? I've muted all the participants. Any other questions you have? Any other doubts or questions you have? You can ask me now. Okay.
Hi. I have a question. Hello.
Would you be able to see that chart I have created? Actually, I don't generally do that. Okay, I'm a systems trader and I don't predict and I don't give analysis. Okay, I either buy or I exit. Okay, that is what I do based on the systems. Okay. You can send me the chart and I can give you my view, but that we may or may not happen. You have to understand that everything is based on probability. Okay, there is no certainty. Okay, if it doesn't happen, you have to exit. Okay. Then Amit is saying, can we get PDF study material for registration? Okay, no, sorry, Amit. PDF study material cannot be given before registration. Okay. Not in terms of analysis. I mean relation to the course. Yeah, if you are like registering with us, then definitely whatever is your view and whatever you understand, you can show me your analysis and I can judge whether it is you are going in the right direction or you are not going in the right direction. And these are the links. Oh, so many indicators. Okay. I'm sorry, I won't be able to judge on such indicators. There are so many indicators. Okay. So I don't use that many indicators. I use either one or two indicators. You have to explain me what you have done. I will not understand what you have done.
I have on the first chart the
study material. Okay, if you register with us, we'll be giving you study material. Any intro to quant system? Like quants will be very basically covered here in level one. Level 2 will have a lot of systematic approach. Okay. So level 2 you can get understand more about quants, but level 1 will not be covering much about quants. Can you share source of you can buy it from the CMT Association website. Okay. I personally like to buy stocks and hold them for a year or two. Okay. Well, I also love to do that. Okay, but then at least you have an exit criteria. Okay, if it doesn't work, then you'll have to exit it. Basically, we have a system which is now a system which holds stocks for almost on an average for 1 year. Okay, so that is good, and you can do that. That's many people actually do that. I also started with that vision. So I'm with CFA and CMT. Basically, what I would say that both are different. CFA covers more of a fundamental analysis, and CMT covers technical analysis. Fundamental analysis is good for stock selection, but for entry exit, CMT will be better. Okay. So basically, both have their own utility, and you can use CFA for fundamental analysis and identify which are the good stocks, and then when to enter that stock and when to exit that stock, that technical analysis will help you more than CFA, because fundamental analysis will not tell you, like they will tell you when to exit, but that will be like quite late. So if you are more into trading and and you believe in exiting earlier, then you should do CFT, otherwise you can do CFT. Can you share total cost of level 1 and full course? Level 1, the CFT association has two options. So basically what they do is, you have to pay three fees there. One is enrollment fee, which is $250. Second is examination, which is $275. And third is annual membership, which is $325. So total it is $850 for level 1. But But then there's another option that you don't pay annual fees and you pay higher exam fees. Okay, so in that case, you have to pay enrollment fee, which is $250, plus you have to pay $475 for a examination fee. Okay, which comes to around $650 or $675. Okay, so either you pay $650 or you pay $800. It is up to you. But any which way, in level 2, you will have to pay that difference. So here, if you are saving $150, then in level 2, you will have to pay $170 extra. Because again, level 2, you will be paying, if you are a member, then you will have to pay $475. But if you are a non-member, then you will have to pay $650. Okay. So any which way, that $170, you will have to pay extra for level 2. And level 3, again, you will have to pay $650 if you are not taking the membership. And you will have to pay $475 if you are taking the membership. So I generally recommend to take membership at least for 1 year. Okay. And then for the next year, you may skip the membership. Okay. And for level 3, you can just give the examination fee, higher examination fee. Okay. At least 1 year, you'll have to, in which case, pay this. And if you are not sure whether you should do or my mobile number or call me, okay, or you can call any of our, yeah, you can note down my details. Okay, if you're interested, you can contact me. Otherwise, if you want to do it on your own, you can do it on your own. Okay. On CMT level 1 basis, are entry level jobs or internship available in order to complete that 3 year work experience? Not sure. Honestly, no. Level 1 will not be enough to give an entry level job. At least you should get clear. Okay. If you are expecting some job working, if you have no experience of technology, then level 1 will not be enough. If you have experience at level 1, then you will be able to work. Okay. But with zero experience, level 1 will not be enough. You are providing all study material and exam papers for practice. This will be giving you study material and practice papers. It's like a Bachelor of Finance qualification mandatory. It's mandatory, but I've never seen they checking that. Okay, so they never ask for a balance sheet of bachelors. Okay, to anybody. Okay. What you can do is, if you are doing it, then you will continue doing CMT and side by side. If you can clear a bachelor, that is a better option. Okay, so that there is no issue with it. Okay. Do we have to buy books or it's included in the fees? It will be included in the fees. The study material will be included in the fees, and that study material will be enough for clearing the exam. I am master in IT. I think that is more than enough. Okay. Master's in IT is like higher than the bachelor's. So I don't think that would be a problem. Okay. Eligibility for level one. Level one you can give without any eligibility. Only eligibility is that the eligibility will arise at the time when you clear level three and you want to get the designation. At that time, you will have to have three things. First is you have to be a bachelor. Second thing, you have to be like 3 years experience. And third is like you need a sponsorship of three CMTs. Okay, so sponsorship of three CMTs will not be an issue because I am one of the CMTs. I will be sponsoring you, and I have various friends in who are CMTs. So I'll get your sponsorship done. Okay. So you don't need to worry about the sponsorship, but yes, the bachelor's and experience you'll have to take care. No finance academic qualification, no. There's no necessity of any financial academic qualification. How to check Indian CMT Level 3 members member list? If you become a member of CMT Association, You will get on the website where you can see how many Indians have cleared level 3 and how many Indians are CMTs. That you will get from the website of CMT Association. That only I think, but you can check on the CMT Association website, maybe without membership also you can see it. I'm not sure. Just check that. I am diploma holder and experience of 10 years. Experience in what? Technical analysis? Then that is fine. Okay, then that is fine. And which is you don't require that designation or that qualification. Yeah. Online study material, or what do you mean by online study material? It will be like, are you from Bombay or are you from any other city? What we'll be doing is that we'll courier you the study material, okay, and some exam papers. Then you can visit us and collect the study material, okay, and this and exam test papers will be emailing it to you after 2 months. We'll be emailing the exam papers because I don't want you to start practicing exam papers now. First, study the full curriculum, finish the full curriculum, reading once at least, and then you can try doing the study material or question papers. Without completing the full curriculum, doing papers is of no use. Okay. And our office is in Andheri. Basically, right now we are in Santacruz West. But within 1 week, we'll be shifting to Andheri. So the classes will be held in Andheri. And it is Andheri East. It's a 10 minutes walk from the station. Okay. From the metro station as well as from the local train station. And we will also be conducting this through webinar. Okay. So any of you who are not in Mumbai, can attend online through a webinar, okay, and like in this same format, okay, on this same platform we'll be doing the classes, and you'll also get recordings of all the lectures. So by any chance, if any of you is not able to attend either in person or on the web, then you'll get the recordings as well. And if you want to see the, if you already attended the lecture, but you want to see the lecture again, you can see the recordings. So recording can be seen n number of times within these 4-5 months. Okay. Till December, you'll be able to see all the recordings. Okay. Any other questions? No, we don't have guns. GAT square of this curriculum. We don't cover GAT. Most of the things which are covered, I've already gone through in this presentation. Okay. You have any other questions? How long does it take to become a CMT? The shortest interval is 1.5 years. So if you clear all the three levels in the first attempt, then and you don't take any break, then within 1.5 years you will be able to become a CMT. Like I cleared all the three levels in the first attempt, and I started in 2012. I did it in 2013. Can you share CMT presentation on my personal reference? Yeah, I can share it. Okay, just put me an email or put me an email, and I'll share it. Just drop me an email and I'll share the presentation. Missed the earlier part of presentation, as can I get a copy of presentation? I'll send you the presentation, and we'll be uploading this on our YouTube channel, and we'll send you the link, and you can see the orientation again. Elliott wave and near wave are covered in CMT course. Elliott wave is covered, but near wave is not covered in CMT. And Elliott wave also, the basic Elliott wave is covered. Advanced Elliott wave or it's not covered in CMT level. Elliott wave is basically covered only in level 1. It is not there in level 2 and level 3. Any other questions? In the presentation, you saw. Website says that to purchase study material, is it compulsory or optional? It is optional. Okay. Like chapter 34 to 40 are like, they are important, and basically, this sentiment measures don't have that much weightage. Okay, statistics also doesn't have a lot of weightage. Probability also doesn't have a lot of weightage. Okay. These chapters don't have much weightage. Okay, only chapter 41 has a lot of weightage. Okay, relative strength is very important, and if you are doing it on your own, then you should not leave this chapter. Okay. What is the eligibility criteria for pursuing a CMT course, and can I give the level 1 exam in my first year of college? Yes, you can give your level in your first year. As I said, it's only required when you give the third level, and when you clear the third level and you are applying for the designation, by that time you should be a bachelor. Okay. So, and then by that time you should have at least 3 years experience. Otherwise, you'll have to wait till you get the experience at the bachelor's degree. Okay. So if you're not done your bachelor by that time, or you're not done and got 3 years experience, then you have to wait for that time till that time you have both of these, and then you can apply for the designation. That's it. Otherwise, if you clear it, that will be secured. You don't need to worry about it. Is there any attempt limit to clear levels? No, there's no attempt limits. You can have n number of attempts. But it is in your own interest that you don't give too many attempts. Because each attempt will cost you 30,000-35,000 rupees extra. Minimum. Who satisfies experience? if I am not doing it on my own. So basically, you have to give your experience details to the CMT Association, and they have a form. You have to fill that form, okay, and then they will judge your experience. Basically, you don't need to have experience only in technical analysis. Even if you have experience in brokerage houses, giving calls, or any financial institution, that will be calculated as your experience. Okay, it doesn't need to be technical analysis only. It can be any finance domain. How strong is the job market for CMT technicians? In India, the job market is not that strong for CMTs as of now. But now CMT Association have opened their own office in India, and in Mumbai it is there. Okay, and now they are doing a lot of attempts to getting recognized in various brokerage houses. People should have a CMT degree to be a technical analyst. Okay. So slowly it is getting recognition, and it is getting its credit. In India, CMT was not getting that much credibility, but now the things are changing. Any other questions? Which is better, CFTA from IIFL or CMTA? Okay, I'll definitely give more value to CMT, because CFTA is like they give you CFTE designation. If you are CMT level 2, if you have cleared CMT level 2. Okay. So if they are giving you designation, you don't need to give their exam also. If you just have CMT level 2, if you are clear CMT level 2, you get a CFTE designation. Okay. So CMT is definitely better than them. Right? Okay. For CMT, you have to clear 3 levels, and for CFTA, you have to only clear 2 levels. How strong is the job market for CMT in USA if I clear CMT? USA is they give a lot of weightage to CMTs. So USA is you'll get more opportunities, and better opportunities there. In India there are less, but in USA they will get better opportunities. I don't know if CMT for job, but will it help in my self-technical analysis? Definitely it will help you in your self-technical analysis. It is more beneficial for self-trading than doing a job, because CMTs, after doing CMT, if you're giving calls to buy and sell, I don't think it's a good use of the designation. Okay. So it's better to do your own trading than to give market calls with a brokerage firm. Are the books from Vidhi Publication enough for CMT level? Yes. Yes, they are enough for the publication. Only thing is that some of the chapters, like quantum figure chapter, is covered in very short. Okay. When I teach, I teach in my own way. In the chapter which is there in the curriculum doesn't shows how to construct a quantum figure chart. So I generally I've made my own study material for quantum figure, and I teach it in my own way. Okay, so quantum figure is something which I don't like the material, which is the chapter which they have given in the material. Okay. It's a good chapter, but then it is very very short. You will not understand quantum figure using that material. Okay, and also Reuters sent the last chapter, 41 chapter. That also chapter, I do it from my, I give my own study material for that because that chapter is very important. And in the study material, what they have given is not a very good chapter. I don't like that chapter. So personally, I do it from my own material. I do it in my own way. But how? But now they don't recommend books. They have their own material, and buying material is mandatory. No, buying material is not mandatory. It's not mandatory. But yes, you have to the portion which is there in their material. Everything will come from that material only. So what we give is that we give our own notes, okay, which cover the full syllabus, okay, and the full curriculum is covered within that. Okay, so. It is up to you whether you want to buy their book or not. Okay. Our study material will be enough for you to clear level 1. And even all the 3 levels, the study material which we give will be enough. Any other questions? Okay, thank you. Which time is coming for you to talk? You can drop me a message on WhatsApp, and then if I'm free, I'll call you back. Okay. Thank you so much for explaining so much. CMT course are theory based or practical. Basically, when we cover the course, we show the charts to the students, because I actually believe that practical knowledge is more important. The book covers the theory part, but then seeing the charts and listening the charts, and then there are not, say, the books will mostly cover only the positive side of it. Like, they will not show you in the book an example which is against the study. Okay, but we also covered that these patterns can fail also. Okay, in the book they show that these patterns can never fail. Okay, which is not true. Okay, all of the patterns fail. Okay, so which should be covered and you'll understand only in practical application. What tip would you give to level CFA students? CFA level 1, I'm not a CFA, okay, so I won't be able to give right advice for them. Okay. Are these CMT passed people available for reference? No, the study material which is there is not the past papers. Okay, it's just a demo paper or a practical paper. It's not the past paper, so it won't be exactly same as others as a paper. Okay, so it cannot be compared with the actual papers. Okay, actual examination will be much difficult than the practical or the demo papers or the test papers. Actual exam is much more difficult. Is CMT useful to develop advanced algorithmic trading strategies? Yes, it is useful. But level 1 will not have much of that concept. Level 2 has a lot of material which will help you to develop algorithmic trading strategies. Like, I developed a lot of strategies from the curriculum itself. Okay, I use a lot of techniques of the curriculum in my trading systems. Whatever I made around 4 trading systems which are running parallelly, and many of those trading systems use the what I've understood from CMT curriculum. And I'll be showing you some of those training systems in the classes, and the results and the traits of those systems. I share that with the students time and again. I share it. What is the procedure to apply for CMT course in India? Basically, you just have to go to the CMT Association website and click on the CMT program and then register for level 1. Okay, you'll have to make 3 payments or 2 payments as per what the choice you take. Okay, and you need an international credit card for it or international debit card. Okay, I am not sure whether net banking will work. Okay, you'll either have to have international debit card or credit card. By 26th August is the date by which you have to pay the fees to the CMT Association. Otherwise, the fees will rise by $100. Okay, so if you are interested, then please pay before 26th. April, and the students which take the classes, we do register for 1 or 2 of the students, so that other students can understand how to register for the CMT course. And you'll have to again register separately for Pro Matric Center and the time slot. So you'll have to take that time slot after you register for the exam. That will be separate registration, which you can do immediately after the paying the fees. Any other questions? What are responsible charges for there is no charges for Pro Matric. That CMT Association, the fees you pay to the CMT Association covers the Pro Matric charges. You don't have to pay anything to Pro Matric. Even if you have any other questions, you can directly WhatsApp me or email me, and I'll be happy to answer them. If you are not remembering something now, if you remember something to ask, you can ask afterwards also. Okay, we'll wind up here. I don't think there's any other questions. Or I'll wait for 1 more minute and then by 6:20 I'll wind up if there are no questions. Thanks a lot, Amit. Thanks, Sandeep. It's up to you, like you can do it on your own also. It's up to you. There's no restriction. Okay. Yes, I will connect to you personally. Need some guidance. I'm working with it right now. Okay, anytime you can call me anytime. If I'm busy, I may answer you later. Okay, just drop your name so that I know who has called. Okay, if I don't answer, and then immediately I'll answer you. Yeah.